International Yoga Day celebration. So today we are celebrating International Yoga Day, not only in Asia, Kolkata, but in India and all over the world. In 2015, it has been started, and being an Indian, we know that yoga is an ancient practice, and
Shambhu Shah. Krishna Bhakta, they are chanting and opening the session. We have arrangements here for chairs. You can sit down on chairs because sitting on the floor aggravates problem of knee joint. Okay, sir. For a few seconds, please sit down, make your mind calm and quiet, prepare your mind for the next session. The most vulnerable part of our body, which connects the brain and the rest of the body, is neck. We start with neck exercise because the neck remains immobile, and we start exercise with the mobility of neck in a scientific way, starting with forward and backward movement. All of you are those who have forward. They just observe and you will gain backward. Okay, sir.
Bend down, slowly bend down.
In deep samadhi.
Thank you.
Voluntarily, we twist our body to remove that congestion. The same thing we will take in the form of upper body twist. This is a very good thing for relieving the congestion in the particular lumbar region. Years, the muscle power becomes weak and the calcium content of the bone becomes, which will invigorate, which will strengthen the quadriceps muscle, the muscles of the thigh, and it will help reduce knee pain. So take the help of knee movement.
Yes. So, slow motion.
thigh should be parallel to the ground and vertebral column straight. The position resembles chair. Now some standing postures. Exercise part is over. Exercise is dynamic movement.
Asana means sthira sukham asanam. Posture will be static and it will generate a pleasing feeling. Here some asanas advocated by Ayush, which we will follow here. The standing posture, talasana. Palm tree, it resembles palm tree. It is a posture for balancing. It is a posture. Yes, Mr. Chakam. Take a deep breath, twist and raise the head. Normal breathing, hold for a few seconds.
This helps concentration of mind. This helps preparing the background for taking another advanced asana, balancing another posture, Vrikshasana. We notice here trees. That tree will be translated into our body language. We will take the form of Vrikshasana. All of you have very perfectly practiced. Next we are coming.
Vasudev sir also, because he has explained it step by step, categorically. Next we come to maximum people we notice suffer from low back pain, lumbar spondylosis.
Take the help, but again,
those who are already suffering from low back pain and lumbar. Breathing normal breathing there. It is very good for removing constipation, indigestion, suffering from constipation, indigestion, dyspepsia, diabetes, take it here. Those who want to increase height, the younger in age, take this herb because it strength, it gives a longitudinal stress of the ventral column. Next we come to Trikonasana. Again twisting posture and
all of you open your legs apart. Now.
This posture you can take if you want to remove the lethargy, want to rejuvenate, want to strengthen quickly. Take this. Next, all of you sit down because standing posture is over. Now we are going to practice some postures sitting on the floor. First, we take the help of Bhadrasana. Actually, this is a combination of different postures. Yoga mudra, when you have bent down, keeping your hand on the back. This is yoga mudra. Actually, intra-abdominal pressure is being increased. And again, when you stretch your entire spinal column, intra-articular column, there is another name, Shashvatasana. So it is a combination of Shashvatasana, Yoga Mudra, Bhadrasana, that is auspicious posture. So you get the benefit of all the postures in one single posture. This is called pelvic basin. When the knees are apart, the pelvic basin gets a stretch. So there is vigorous blood circulation in this area. This is particularly ideal for ladies. Ladies suffering from dysmenorrhea, there is pain during menstruation, excessive flow. Amenorrhea, no menstruation cycle at all. Or erratic menstruation, take the help of this thing. And nowadays, another disease which is become very much prevalent, which is noticeable, that is polycystic ovary. Young people means young women, they suffer from this polycystic ovary. Take the help of this auspicious posture, Bhadrasana, regularly maintain your weight, do some physical exercises, and you will be relieved from polycystic ovary. Actually, according to the mobility of joints, gradually this is being increased. First, those who are less mobile take the help of Ardha Ushtrasana, then Ushtrasana on toe, then full Ushtrasana. So in this graduated way, we go to the ultimate objective, that is Ushtrasana. And what I was telling that, Vajrasana, very simple posture, but very beneficial. I am explaining why. Vajrasana, look, everyone does it. Everyone can do it, but no, not everyone. Suffering from knee joint pain, don't sit on the floor, don't sit on the Vajrasana. So for them, Vajrasana is prohibited. If you practice this asana just after meal, then digestive power is being increased. Why? Very few people know why the digestive power is being increased. They say because it is written in the book, Vajrasana after meal. Look, I am explaining. Here is the heart. It is pumping blood throughout the root and corner of the body. But you see, the distance of circulation has been minimized. There is no circulation of blood from here to tip of the toes. Circulation in this area is being prohibited, cancelled, reduced. So where the body circulates blood? Only the upper part. So there is maximum circulation of blood where in this region and in this region. What is situated in this region and here? Heart is situated, lungs is situated, liver is situated, intestine is situated. Blood rushes there, blood carries all the nutrients and oxygen. So the digestion is being improved. We get better digestion, taking the help of Vajrasana. But this is not explained. Very few people know that. So in case of ischemia, do you know ischemia? Right, it is a crime that I want blood, I am not getting. So there is pain. Ischemia is this thing. Ischemia does not mean that only lack of circulation in the heart. There may be ischemia.
Vajrasana or Vajrasana, Gamukhasana in Vajrasana. Say this thing. You do the Gamukhasana. Again, you see, the circulatory path is being reduced. Blood circulates only to this area, and
you will feel it, you will realize it. Stay in this posture for a bit, then blood rushes.
Next, take the help of Vakrasana. That is a bit difficult. Vakrasana, Adila posture kapara. Vakra means crooked, crooked, twisting. This is the posture advocated by Yush. House has advocated this. Yes. Please explain. Look, yes, I know the problem, I know the problem and I know the solution. Yes, look how people are striving, how people are fighting for this.
Buddha is their posture.
What the posture is with elbow flexion.
Now just follow this. Just remember.
Yes.
This stays straight and you flex the knee with the opposite hand. Left leg with right hand and the other hand your back and twist in that direction.
ये भी थोड़ा difficult हो जाता है ना? ये भी थोड़ा difficult हो जाता है. तो solution क्या है? अच्छा, all of you sit down.
By folding both the legs. Yes. Sit down with folding legs. No problem. Holding like me, the problem is
at the floor.
spine should be straight. Give a twist. Normal breathing. Yes. ठीक है आसानी है हाँ ठीक है ना आसानी है ना तो ठीक है भाई कुछ चेक करो
प्रोन पोस्चर भुजंगासन
and that is why the name goes Bhujangasana. In Bhujangasana, the vertebral column gets a backward arch, back bending, and on the lower abdomen there is pressure. So those suffering from lower abdominal pain or there is deposition of oil fat in the abdominal area, this back stretch removes the fat, strengthening the muscles of the abdomen. Again, this is a combination posture. Combination of Bhujangasana and Salavasana is equal to Chaturasana. For improving kidney function, for improving the function of the lungs, for removing the congestion in the low back region,
Santulasana. Santulasana. Oh, put your legs. established abdomen, that is the abdominal muscles are moving, and it comes down, but only in the abdominal area, then it is called Sutta Padasana. Now, your body relax all the parts of your body, breathing normal.
On your body.
sultry weather, when all are perspiring profusely, take the help of Shitali Pranayama and experience a cooling effect on your body, on your mind. Picture of any your guru or sound or beautiful flower, whatever you want. Imagine that in front of you, visualize that with that attention. Sometimes mind bhatak jayega. उसमें कुछ हर्ज नहीं. यू ट्यून अगेन एंड विजुअलाइज इन फ्रंट ऑफ योर क्लोज आईज एंड रिमेन फॉर सम टाइम.
coming over